Theorem 2, an arbitrary intersection of left ideals of a ring is a left ideal of the ring. ये थ्योरम आसान है देखने में, देखो इसका प्रूफ. लेट आर बी अ रिंग एंड लेट एस टी वेयर स्मॉल टी बिलोंग्स टू कैपिटल टी बी एनी फैमिली ऑफ लेफ्ट आइडियल्स ऑफ आर. यहाँ पर कैपिटल टी क्या है, ये एक इंडेक्स सेट है. इंडेक्स सेट इट कैन बी अ सेट ऑफ इंटीजर्स और सेट ऑफ नेचुरल नंबर्स एंड सो ऑन. तो एग्जाम्पल क्या होगा इसका, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड सो ऑन हो जाएगा. Here T is an index set and is such that for all small t in capital T, ST is a left ideal of R. Let capital S is equal to intersection small t in capital T ST, क्योंकि हमें arbitrary intersection लेना है of all left ideals और ST हमारा left ideal है. It will contain all X in R such that X belongs to ST for all small t in capital T. This be the intersection of this family of left ideals of R. Then to prove that S is also a left ideal of R. यही प्रूव करना है कि an arbitrary intersection of left ideals of ring R is a left ideal of the ring. Obviously S will not be your phi because at least the element 0 is in ST for all T in capital T. So this S cannot be phi. Means it is not an empty set. Now let AB be any two elements of this S. AB belongs to S implies AB belongs to ST because this S is an intersection of all ST. So AB will be in your ST for all small t in capital T. It means A minus B will be in ST for all t in capital T. Why? Because ST is a left ideal of R. Therefore, this will be in ST. It means A minus B will be in the intersection of ST over T in capital T. It implies that A minus B belongs to S. Because this is your S, so A minus B will be in S. Now, let A be any element of S and small r be any element of capital R. Then A belongs to S implies A belongs to intersection ST over T. It means A belongs to ST for all small t in capital T. Therefore, R into A belongs to ST for all t in capital T. Why? Because this ST is a left ideal. So, since RA is in each ST, therefore RA will be in the intersection of ST over T. It means RA belongs to S. So we have A minus B belongs to S and RA belongs to S. Thus AB belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S and R small r belongs to capital R, A belongs to S implies RA belongs to S. Therefore this S is your left ideal of R. So this theorem is proved. Next, there is a definition, the smallest left ideal containing a given subset. See the definition. Let M be a non-empty subset of a ring R. We have a ring R and a subset, non-empty subset M. Then a left ideal of I of R is called the smallest left ideal of R containing M. If I contains an M and if I is contained in every left ideal of R containing M. Yani ki jo subset M hai wo I mein hai aur I har left ideal mein hai. यही कहता है कि if I contains M and if I is contained in every left ideal of R containing M, तो I क्या हो जाएगा हमारा, ये smallest हो जाएगा. The smallest left ideal of R containing M is called the left ideal generated by M and we will denote it by M within small brackets. It can be easily seen that the intersection of the family of left ideals containing M is the left ideal generated by M. Since intersection is the smallest है, तो ये क्या हो जाएगा, left ideal generated by capital M. Similarly, हम इसको define कर सकते हैं right ideal कहके. So after this, हम लोग के पास है definition and theorem, sum of two left ideals. Theorem, the left ideal generated by the union I1 union I2 of two left ideals is the set I1 plus I2 consisting of the elements of R obtained on adding any element of I1 to any element of I2. Let us see its proof. Let A1 plus A2 and B1 plus B2 be in I1 plus I2. Then this A1 be in I1 and B1 be in I1. It means A1, B1 both are in I1. Similarly, A2, B2 both are in I2. Now it is given that I1, I2, they are left ideals of R. Therefore, they are subgroups of the additive group of R. Therefore, A1, B1 belongs to I1. It implies that A1 minus B1 belongs to I1. And A2, B2 belongs to I2. It implies that A2 minus B2 belongs to I2. Consequently, A1 plus A2 minus B1 plus B2 is equal to A1 minus B1 plus A2 minus B2 belongs to I1 plus I2. Why? Because this A1 minus B1 is in I1 and A2 minus B2 is in I2. Therefore, I1 plus I2 is a subgroup of the additive group of R. Now, let small r be in capital R and A1 plus A2 belongs to I1 plus I2. Then A1 belongs to capital I1, A2 belongs to capital I2. Then R into A1 plus A2 will be R A1 plus R A2. And since R A1 is in I1 and R A2 is in I2, therefore they will be in I1 plus I2. Why? Because I1 is a left ideal and I2 is also a left ideal. So since I1 is a left ideal, therefore R A1 will be in I1 and similarly R A2 will be in I2. Therefore this I1 plus I2 is a left ideal of R. Now, since 0 belongs to I2, therefore A1 belongs to I1 can be written as A1 plus 0. Therefore, A1 belongs to I1 implies A1 belongs to I1 plus I2. Therefore, this I1 is contained in I1 plus I2. Similarly, we can show that I2 is contained in I1 plus I2. Both of these imply that I1 union I2 is contained in I1 plus I2. Means they are, this, it is a subset of I1 plus I2. It means I1 plus I2 is a left ideal containing I1 union I2. तो ये बिगर हो गया, ये स्मॉलर हो गया, ये इसको कंटेन कर रहा है, I1 plus I2 कंटेन कर रहा है I1 union I2 को. Also, if any left ideal contains I1 union I2, then it must contain I1 plus I2. Therefore, I1 plus I2 is the smallest left ideal containing I1 union I2. Therefore, this I1 plus I2 is equal to the left ideal generated by I1 union I2. It means I1 union I2 within small brackets. Similarly, we can show for right ideals. So this theorem is also proved. Next, we have some examples. See here, example one. The set N of all 2x2 matrices of the form A, B, 0, 0, means second column is 0. For A, B integers, here A, B are integers. It is a left ideal, but not right ideal in the ring R of all 2x2 matrices with elements as integers. All elements are integers. Here, N is the subset of R consisting of those elements whose second column contains only zero. See here, second column elements are zero. See its solution. Let A is equal to AB00, B is equal to CD00, be any two elements of N, be any two elements of N, then capital A minus capital B will be AB00 minus CD00 matrices. This is equal to matrix A minus C, B minus D00. So it will be in N because second column is 0. So it will be in N. Therefore, this N is a subgroup of R under addition. Now let U is equal to WXYZ be any element of R and A is equal to AB00 be any element of N. Then U into A will be WXYZ AB00. So it can be written as row by column multiplication. Apply row by column multiplication. WA plus XB, this is your 0. And YA plus ZB, this is your 0. It will also be in N. Why? Because the second column is 0. Therefore, this N is a left ideal of R. Why? Because A minus B belongs to N and UA belongs to N. So this is a left ideal of R. Now we need to show that it is not a right ideal. Since 1100 belongs to N and 1021 belongs to R. But the product 1100 into 1201 is equal to 1212. It is not in N. Why? Because the second column is not zero. So this N is a left ideal but not a right ideal. It means this problem is solved. Next, there is another problem. Example two. If small m is a fixed integer, the set P of integers given by P is equal to x into m, such that this x is an integer, it is an ideal of the ring R of all integers. So take x1m and x2m, any two elements of P, because P contains elements of the type x into m, where x is an integer. So your x1, x2 both are integers. Then x1, x2 are some integers. Then evaluate x1m minus x2m. It will be x1 minus x2 into m. This x1 minus x2 is your integer. So this product will also be in a P, because the P contains x into m type elements. Therefore, this x1 minus x2 is also an integer. Therefore, P is a subgroup of R under addition. Now, suppose small r be an integer, it means small r be any element of capital R, and x into m be an element of P, then R into xm is equal to Rx into m belongs to P. Why? Because this Rx is also an integer. Therefore, this capital P is a left ideal of R. But since R is a commutative ring, so if Rxm belongs to P, then Xrm will also be in P. Therefore, this P is an ideal of R. So this is also solved. There is another example. See, the set of integers I is only a subring, but not an ideal of the ring of rational numbers. See, solution. The product of rational number, take a rational number 2 by 5 and an integer 3, multiply both of them. So it will be 2 by 5 into 3 means 6 by 5. But it is not an integer. Since it is not an integer, therefore this I is not an ideal of the ring of rational numbers. Next, there is another example. The set Q of rational numbers is only a subring, but not an ideal of the ring of real numbers, R plus dot C. The product of a rational number and a real number is not necessarily a rational number. See here, this is your real number 1 by 2, and this is your rational number root 7, and this is equal to root 7 by 2. See, this is your rational number 1 by 2, root 7 is your real number, but their product is not a rational number. So therefore, this Q is not an ideal of the ring of real numbers. So this is all about for today, and if you have any query, you just send me a message and make a note of all this. The same will be available on my YouTube channel. You can watch the lecture from that YouTube channel also.